Hello and welcome back to another episode of Avin It Large. I'm your host, Captain Birdyman FM, and welcome to the story of Unión Deportiva Ibiza. And today I've got to start this episode with an announcement. This will be the last episode of Avin It Large. I just don't have the same connection to Ibiza as I did in previous seasons, in season number 5. And if I just show you the schedule, we've just gone through an absolute torrid run and then just got a win in the last game. And I just don't have the energy to go through another season where we finish in the playoffs and then we lose in the playoffs and then we have to do it all over again. It's just Groundhog Day. And I want to try out other FM experiments. I want to try other saves. I've just started a journeyman save, the Mike Bassett story, 442. And I don't do this full time. And doing two saves just takes up too much of my time. I have to do one or the other. So I just put all my attention into one. And unfortunately, Beef has just taken a bit of a back step. And editing's been down, and releases have been down, and views have been down. And I'm not really bothered about the views, if I'm completely honest with you. I just want to entertain, I just want to have fun while doing it, because that's all I do it for, really. So, yeah, after this, 3 defeats in a row, we did get a win. It just doesn't feel right. And by saying it doesn't feel right, I mean being at the club anymore, and it feels the right time to kind of just let it go. I've taken as far as we could go. Before I do resign, I'm just going to go and have a look at some of like the best 11 and some of the records. It's a better review of what we did. So this, obviously, last season was our best 11. Some notable big name players in there. Number one always speaks out for me, though, is Marco Borriello. He was there in our first season and he will be remembered for absolutely forever. So thank you, Marco, for making that first season. Ooh, just one to remember, believe me. Let's have a look at his career stats. 21 goals in 37 appearances overall. What a legend. So in our first season, we finished 3rd in the league in the Spanish Second Division B4, which automatically gave us a promotion to the league above. And we've been in this league ever since, finishing 4th in our first season, which got us into the playoffs, finishing 4th in the season after that, 2nd last season, and then this season, we're just out of the playoffs, just not feeling it. I'm going to say it a million and one times. I ain't feeling it anymore, guys. The club has risen, though, since I took over. I think this was around here, 18-19. Went down a couple of times, but back up to where it needs to be. Just so close to getting that promotion last season. Just missed out. This is the thing where I'm most pleased about. When we first started, we were in mega, mega, mega debt. I mean, that's £1.8 million in debt at one point, and I've got us up to £1.7 million in the black. I did come in as a businessman on this series and I've done quite well, I think, to say we only get 200 fans a week. So that's it. That's me. That's where I'm going to leave it with Ibiza. We started with nothing. We did all right. It's not my most successful campaign I've ever had on Football Manager, but it was the first crack at FM19 and I didn't lose my job. That's the most important thing. We nearly did lose it, but 5 years down the line, 35 now, 5 years down the line, and we're still in the same position. And yeah, it's just not getting any better. Oh no, before we actually go, just have a quick look at the overview. So I spent 1,677 days at the club. We played a total of 196 games and we won 100 out of that. And I think that is very, very good if I'm going to blow up my own trumpet. 51% win percentage is pretty decent. Highest we ever spent on a player was £1,500, and that was James Abubakar, and we sold Yildiz last summer for £1.8 million. So I've not done too bad. That's not bad for a salesman. Not bad at all. Well, it's not giving me the option to resign unless that's on my... there we are. Resign immediately. Bye-bye, everyone. And there we go. Birdyman quits. Can Mises post. Captain Birdyman has decided to end the reign at Cambizes by resigning from his position as manager. He'd been the manager for the last couple of years and he's currently sitting in 5th place and has lost 3 out of his last 5 games. They're now looking for a new manager. The internal candidate is Pedro Menuntes. Comes with a strong reputation and close to a slight favourite for the job. He probably will get it, actually. I brought him in as a coach and he's already caretaker manager now, so he'll probably get the job anyway. But yeah, that's it. Has anyone left? Apparently some staff have left. Here we are. Who are they? Pezzo. Torrado. Oh! Juan Luis Funites, my assistant manager, cannot go on without me. So that's it. That's it. That's the end. That is the end of this Ibiza journey. I just want to say thank you to everyone that tuned in, watched it, commented, shared it, did what you needed to do to really make this journey what it was for me. I really enjoy myself, but it's not the end. I will be back with my new unemployed journeyman save, and it's got a very special twist. Mike Bassett, Football Manager 442 special. We're going to be bringing Mike and we're going to take him from absolute nowhere to the top of English football to get him the job of his dreams, which is the England manager position. So please do like the video if you do like it. Continue to support me on the other save that we're running. Subscribe to my channel, follow me on Twitter. You know the business. I will see you very soon. Bye-bye.
Hello, party people. This is Captain Kim speaking. Welcome aboard Benga Airways. After takeoff, we'll pump up the sound system because we're going to...